at Robin Hood. Do you take from the rich and the poor and us? Wearing diamond shoes while you walk your pubs in a town we create where there ain't no love.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Pacific Northwest at Lumen Field in Seattle, Washington. These folks love their football in Seattle. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad came out of the tunnel, and it was just absolutely deafening in this building. They're set for football, so are we, as the Seahawks get set to match up with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light thing. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Now Brees finding Kamara, and he'll get it up here this time to the 21. It's a gain of 7, and it'll be second down. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
The first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Shotgun now for Brees. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 38-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Throw. He gets this one complete to Traquan Smith. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Back to the ground. It's Kamara. Good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
Four receivers in the formation here. 3 to the left, 1 to the right, 2nd and 3. To throw is Brees. Eluding the pressure right. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Working from the gun, it's Brees. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Drew Brees on target to Emmanuel Sanders. And the Saints take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. And it's good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead.
The score is Saints 7, Seahawks nothing.
after the touchdown. Lutz to kick it off. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone.
Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now first and 10 at their 25-yard line. This is Rashad Penny, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package, and that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
On second and 11 now, Wilson. And the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
I don't think there's anyone who could possibly doubt how fast he could run in the open field. But if there were, he silenced those thoughts there.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Now Wilson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. DK Metcalf, 46 yards. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
On the return, Deontay Harris. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
3 yards the gain there, second down.
Second and 7 at the 29-yard line.
From the gun, it's Breeze. Flush to his right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. But prior to that, he had hit his first 6 passes to start the game, so on a nice little run to begin.
It feels like this offense has carried its dress rehearsal into the game. You know, because you do practice it, you do go through it, and in this case, it is clicking exactly like they drew it out.
Hauled in downfield, and he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That gain on third down, good for 28.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
plays on third down. And that's caught by Smith. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
That is caught right at the 10-yard line. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Again, it's Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And the Saints are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one.
A gain of eight brings
it. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. They'll run it with Kamara, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. Boy, such a good drive. You'd hate to have it end in three. Do you think about going for it?
Absolutely. I mean, the fact that they moved the ball so well should lead you to the decision that maybe we should go for it right here. Also, as a head coach, show some confidence in your team. Let them know you think they can go get it.
They'll go for it. It's Breeze. And my goodness, this is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Seahawks able to come up with a goal line stand. They'll start on the ground. It's Rashad Penny. And he's upended at the 6 as they double their room to maneuver on a pickup of 3.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they gave up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being...
It got his man complete. 20, 10. Ooh. Touchdown, Seattle! Russell Wilson with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. That could be an important swing right there. A touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first 2 quarters.
And that is caught for the 2 points. So they're able to throw it in for the 2-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here because if you do get it intercepted, it's returned by the defense. That's 2 points for them, but he identified an open target and put it right on him.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's Quentin Dunbar with a pick. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Coaches preach all the time about opportunities and taking advantage of them, and he did exactly that. I used to have a coach tell us all the time, a lost opportunity is never regained. Well, no regrets here. He picked that one off and took it to the house.
And this one through the uprights and good.
Seahawks 21, Saints 7.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
First down, Saints.
To throw, it's Breeze. Left side here to Sanders. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. That first down completion only netted them three. Second and seven. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
First down.
He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. Thomas, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Second and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Now, Breeze again. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Looking to go back to Thomas again. And it's third down. To throw again. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now fourth down.
Let's go! Let's go!
Brings up fourth down.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And that is no good. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. And this carries into the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10. At their own 20-yard.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Penny, a first down carry. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant...
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Credit that sack to Marcus Davenport.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go to the lockers with that 2-3-score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Wilson and the offense not coming off the field. They're going for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth with Wilson. And that's complete to Luke Wilson. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
And good running, going to get this down close to a first at the Saints 36.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. He's going to go for a big play downfield. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
And now look at him go. He's at the 50, the 30, past the 20. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, 98 yards. And the Saints have cut it back within a score. Alvin Kamara, Charles, a guy from your alma mater there in Knoxville, and he has developed into a perennial Pro Bowler on the strength of big plays like we just saw there.
And that's why he's one of the best running backs in the game today, because this run combined all the elements. Started with patience, and he was just waiting for the right lane to materialize. Then once he saw it, he used his speed and escapability in tandem and turned this into a tremendous play.
And in terms of distance covered there, next-gen stats showing us he actually traveled better than 100 yards all told on that one.
I want my money back. What are you doing?
Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Out routes are always timing routes. And if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. Looked like he led him a little too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second because he caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Cameron Jordan wreaking havoc with a sack.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. But I believe a Seahawk was able to get a handle on this, so this will remain Seattle ball. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's the Saints who hold the football, but they're trailing as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
He was brought down at the 8-yard line. A gain of 9 brings up second and 1.
Again, it's Kamara. And here he'll get it down to the 7.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down seven. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. Now he's forced out left. And now he's, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown.
There you go. Got him again.
Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
I'd have to say we're all a little bit surprised there, because at his age, with his speed, or should I say lack thereof, the only rushing touchdowns I would expect are on quarterback sneaks. But here, he found all of his guys covered, and he said, why not? And by the way, if that doesn't fire up your team to see the veteran like that risking his body for the touchdown, I don't know what will.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. From the shotgun, Wilson. And finding the tight end, Wilson. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
I like what I'm seeing from them here. A tight game in the fourth quarter. They understand the situation. They don't need to be in any rush. Go ahead and huddle up and run your offense. That last completion put them in a nice position to take the lead this game.
And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 2nd and very short.
46-yard line, 10 yards on the pickup. It's 2nd.
Again, it's Penning. And good running, going to get this down close to a first at the Saints 42. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Brandon, I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Play action. It's Wilson. Being chased out left. He's going to take off with it. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
It goes as a loss of 6. And now 3rd down.
The tackle made back at the 44-yard line.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Demario Davis. And a terrific return as he brings this one all the way back to the 30. So how about that for a momentum switch?
We're in the fourth quarter and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here. Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. They run it again with Kamara. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Now the Seahawks call the second of their 3 timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. On 3rd down, here's Kamara. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Saints 1st down there on a gain of 11.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over 150 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
On the Seahawks 20-yard line.
And they get the timeout called here. It comes with 1 second remaining on the clock. So it all rests now on the right leg of Will Lutz. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. So it all rests now on the right leg of Will Lutz. The clock showing just 1 tick. This for the win. And it's good. He got it. He missed his long attempt earlier, but he connects when it matters most. And Bourbon Street, it'll be alive tonight. The Saints have won it. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do.